Hi students, welcome to another session. So far we are dealing with unit 4, that is human development. We have understood the meaning of development and factors influencing development, and we have seen the growth of human being in terms of physical, cognitive and socio-emotional processes. Today's topic is to understand few differences between these similar words such as growth, development, maturation, evolution. So today's topic is, so growth, development, maturation and evolution. So let us see what is there in this session. So growth refers to an increase in the size of body parts or of the organism as a whole. It is in some way, growth refers to physical component in terms of what you see, that are, it can be measured or quantified. For example, growth in height. Yes, it can be in either meters or centimeters or feet, inches. These are the units of measurement. And weight. Weight like cages. Generally, it is cages or lobes. So these can be physically seen. These changes can be physically seen in our body. That is physical body. So what it is saying is that growth refers to is increasing size in body parts. That is, when you are in a child, you have a very less body. That is small hands, small legs. And when you grow with the time, you grow in terms of height. And weight. Generally, a baby, born baby, will be around 1.5 kgs to 2.5 kgs on an average. And then a grown-up individual is around 60 to 80 kgs. So what is happening here? There is a height and weight which can be physically observable. So growth refers to physical components that an organism, either size of an organism, particularly size of the organism, here it is the human being, can be measured and quantified, measured or quantified. So in terms of units, or quantified means it can be measured and then it is turned into numbers. So this is what the growth is. So next it is development. And as the unit itself says, is human development. Development is a process by which an individual grows and changes throughout the life cycle. Means it is a continuity process. That is what, from birth to death. So it is a process that individual happens, it is a lifelong process. The term development applies to the changes that have a direction and hold definite relationship with what precedes it. Means, for example, we'll be seeing these examples and in turn will determine what will come after. Means, for example, you can say developed. It developed from this state to this state. So it is a comparison. So what is the state, present state? What is the earlier state? What is the next state or stage? So these can be observed. These can be determined. These can be explained by comparing the earlier stage and the post stage. That's what the term development applies to, the changes that have direction, which means in a forward direction or a backward direction, that it can be compared, which is precede and what will come after. This is what a development can be. can be explained, can be understood. A temporary change caused by brief illness, for example, is not considered as a part of development. For example, see, all changes occurs as a result of development are not same of kind. So we'll be seeing an example here. What it is saying is that a sudden change when, for example, an individual who is growing has a broken leg or a fracture or some, it can be physical growth and a mental growth or some disease which obstructed his development. But it is a temporary phase, right? But overall, the individual grows. Even though there is some break or anything, the development is continuous. Small changes in the meanwhile doesn't be considered as part of development. That's what here it is. Even we will have some obstructions. A human life is a bigger process. So even we will be understanding this in the part of evolution. All changes that occur result of development are not same of kind. And again, it is the development of individual differs in physical factors and other factors based on the many conditions we have seen in that factors, right? Thus, changes in size, changes in proportion. What do you see in the development? It is physical, it is in size. The development in size, that is growth, proportion. It is like how it is changing from a child to adult is a proportion. The change is a proportion. Changes in features, like for example, say a child will have bones, more bones, and as you grow, there will be, I think, around 216, and then it is 206. So the bones will be, and the physical body of a child is more flexible than a grown-up individual. So he can use the body in what way it is. And then as a grown-up, there will be a fixed movements. Okay, so these are the features. These can be said as features. And even, for example, maybe teeth will be very less, and as a grown-up individual, you will have 32 and 28 and 32 according to the requirements of the particular state and age. Acquiring new features are varied in their pace. For example, at a physical level, you will have the biological growth, genetical changes, for example, facial hair, voice change. These are the examples we can discuss in terms of features, new features and the part features. As well. Development includes growth as one of its aspects. So growth is part of development. That is, physical growth is a part of development. So this is what we have to growth in terms of physical, as we discussed in the earlier slide. So growth is part of the development. Development is having some features. Change in size, proportion, and features. These are the three: size, proportion from one stage to another stage, and features. So these are the things we have to consider. So moving to next slide. So next is maturation. So now we have seen growth, development, growth as a part of development. Now we will see maturation. Maturation is mature, is refers to the changes that follow an elderly order sequence that are largely dictated by the genetic blueprint. Means maturation is completely related to, in some way, are mostly related to biological process. In the earlier, we have seen development in terms of physical, and now it is biological process, which we have that during the evolution process we discussed. That is enculturation, which we considered in which we discussed in the earlier sessions. in enculturation, the features from parents are transferred to the next offspring. So which produces commonalities in our growth and development. For example, see, all human beings' physical structure is same. The changes, stage by stage changes are also same. At adolescent, you will have changes. And even here is an example. For example, most children can sit in 7 months, stand in 8 months, walk in 1 year. This is similar to every healthy human being, right? There can be little differences, but on an average, this physical change or and even there is a another factor which we have discussed is biological. Once the underlying physical structure is sufficiently developed, for example, a baby which has grown for a weight of 5 kgs, it is physically developed, and again the biological factors can contribute for these features. Sitting is a feature, standing is a feature, walking is a feature of the human being. So these are the things which comes under maturation. The biological factors with the help of physical development can help the individual develop. Once the underlying physical structure is sufficiently developed, proficiency in these behaviors require adequate environment. And there is also another thing is environment. There should be environment to sit. There should be environment to walk. If in a cage or a confined environment, you cannot walk, right? So these are the things and practice. So biological factors, which will be ready. The emotional development in the children is ready. And even physical development is ready. And there should be the environment should be in favor. However, special efforts to accelerate these buffer do not help in the infant if maturationally not ready. For example, if you see in an example like the voice changes generally you cannot observe in the very baby. You can only see during the adolescence. The facial hair, the physical changes, the maturation, the cycles, menstrual cycles, etc. All these factors can be. The physical growth can also be observed during the adult stage, not in the baby. So these are the examples that give you maturation is a part of physical growth and biological growth, that is genetical factors. Environmental factors has to improve, and even there should be some practice, some changes which has to be initiated from the individual himself or the people around him or her. However, special efforts to accelerate these, these cannot be once only maturationally you are ready, these factors can come out. So these are the things, and it is stage by stage. So these processes seem to unfold from within, following an inner genetically determined timetable. Yes, this is the timetable which we are discussing, from child, adult, adolescent, adult, and old age. So gray hair, the maturity, the thinking capabilities, or the declining will be happening in the only old age. These are the stages which you have in maturation. So basically, you have seen growth, development, and maturation. So what is there in the next? Let us see. So next is evolution. Evolution refers to species-specific changes. For example, here, from monkey to man. Monkey to man. So let us see, take a monkey as a this, man as this. Okay, so evolution refers to species specific changes, species. So Homo sapiens is a species we will be discussing. Natural selection is an evolutionary process, the fittest and the finest, which we discussed in the earlier sessions. The fittest animal will survive that evolution process. Individuals that are best adapted to survive and reproduce survive and repeat due to the conditions. Like, see, in the pandemics and epidemics, natural disasters, all these are obstacles for a human being. And even the birth of a child itself is it's a journey from a seed to a plant. That is in the beginning of the slide itself. During the growth, you will encounter many challenges. Every stage will have its own difficulties and challenges, hurdles. So, what happens? A man who has grown from 0 to 40 years will have some changes in his mental growth and physical growth. These physical changes are transferred genetically and with the chromosomes or genes to next generation. These are the changes which has happened in the earlier generation, and these will be transferred to the next generation. So evolution proceeds at a very slow pace. And yes, in the earlier example, we considered 0 to 40 years, one generation, 1 to 100 years will be taken, and an average 20 to 30 years for a change to happen in an individual. Emergence of human beings from great apes took around 14 million years from that stage, from the ape animal stage to human being stage. It took 14 million years. The evolution, which the digital age which we are enjoying, is also a growth of 2000 years. There is mechanization, electrification, and then digitization. So industrialization is also a development which we can compare. It has been estimated that Homo sapiens, the human beings which we are today, came into exist just only 50,000 years ago. So these are the examples which we can discuss. So you have evolution is a species specific, and it is about survival and reproduction. So earlier, growth is physical. Development is both physical, and that is, you can see as a units which you can discuss. And maturation, it is genetical. Evolution, it is species oriented. So these are the differences you can understand in terms of growth, development, and then maturation and evolution. So I think that's ends up this session. Yeah, so that is all for today. Thank you so much for your time. If you have any queries, just write to the mail ID. Have a great day. We'll meet in the next session. Thank you.